about Envy from last year with Trill, right?
Yeah.
I think Gator and Trill can definitely draw the same conclusions.
Mm-hmm. And Atlanta Academy know where to draw the line most of the time. And Legion's going to match them here. Goats beat Goats. Rolf still on the Zenyatta. Atlanta really preferring to run Kodak on the Moira. So, you know that you have the advantage in the shield break. You know that you can get more burst damage in with the help of that Discord. So try and play around that. Atlanta Academy like to take these fights very proactively and just rush you when you least expect it. So Legion need to be playing with, both eyes peeled at all times.
I think Moira's damage can't be understated as well. You're going to be doing a lot of healing, but when that coalescence comes out, it's a little bit of column A, a little bit of column B. You get the healing, you get the damage, and you get a ton of control and tempo, because you're most likely going to have your ultimate first out of anyone in the game if you're playing the Moira. Kodak is going to be showing up on it this week. I think Kodak has probably played Moira than any other support so far this season, and it's a very unique look that Atlanta Academy can run.
Oh, man, everybody's... Nobody on the Academy, Atlanta Academy team skips leg day. And I just want to point out the way that Legion took that high ground. So when I say that I don't think just swapping comps is going to solve their problem, sure, you can think about counters to Goats, but you need to approach these fights as though you can win them. Stan One kind of poking his head out of the door, the only one on the high ground there, gets immediately stunned and deleted by Legion, and the rest of their team were still 4 seconds behind. Gladiator's Legion can't allow that kind of miscommunication or tentativeness against Atlanta.
Rolf is going to have that transcendence, so he can either export his heat or defend against the Graviton Surge. Hopefully it's to defend, because you really in this situation aren't looking for offensive orientation or ultimates. And the ultimates all come online for Atlanta Academy at around the same time. They're going to go to use the Rally and Coalesce to start things off, and no one from Atlanta Academy has died since the fall. That is a crazy statistic to think about. Is Kodak going to find another kill? Saucy going to be putting those melees in. You want to do that if you're Zarya. You're actually going to get more damage if you melee during that Graviton Surge, but there's no damage really coming in from Legion. Everyone from Atlanta Academy continues the streak from Paris.
Uh-huh, and Rolf there tried to save Water's life. Water the first one to go down. He does have this habit when he is playing Brigitte to be the first member of Legion down, and you just can't afford that, because when your Zen's forced to use Transcendence to save a Brig, save a Rhyne, that means that ATL get a free grab every single time.
There is a grab only on one side, and this time it's going to be for Legion. This is a really good opportunity for Legion to get at least some picks, potentially the point, if they use their ultimates correctly. There is no trance on their side, however, or Atlanta Academy's, because they're not running that Zenyatta, so that big AoE healing is only going to be for Legion. They're actually getting close to that transcendence. If they have it, then they can feel a little bit better about approaching this point, but they've got to do something. They can't just keep letting Atlanta Academy pepper in that damage against them. The Earthshatter goes down, Sugar Free. It's going to be on the ground. Are they finally going to get the pick? No, they will not. As Hawk going to get a self-destruct kill. No one has died on Atlanta Academy since Nepal. That was 2 maps ago.
Oh, no. Like, Gladiator's Legion.
Get it out, you can do it.
I can do it. Legion can do it. I believe they can do it. When they have the tools, they don't have the confidence to do it. And then when Dalton finally drops grab, nobody's prepared. Atlanta Academy were waiting. They're the birds of prey. They drop down right on top of Legion while they were, fuffing about, poking. And you don't poke against Atlanta. You cannot poke against this team. You gotta go in decisively, and now they don't have grab.
Graviton Surge is gonna come out from Atlanta Academy, start things off. There is a self-destruct, still no casualties for Atlanta Academy. Dalton gonna try to get a little bit more energy in his play. A little scared. It's hard not to. This is the Atlanta Academy team that you're facing off against. Rolf has that transcendent stand one. Could turn things around with an Earth Shatter. Let's see if it's gonna be the same saving potential. Oh. Two are on the ground. Two, three, and Hawk. Hawk is going to get Nima. Gator is gonna go down as well. So they do finally get the pick they need. And Gladiator's Legion in the thick of time could be taking this first point. It looks like they will, as Atlanta Academy streak will be broken here. That is the first time someone from Atlanta Academy has died since our first map today. But Gladiator's Legion don't care about that streak. All they care about is capturing this point.
Now, and they will do so in the nick of overtime, but it was all due to a crucial boop by Luddy. Boops Gator into the air as Stan One shatters the ground underneath him. Really well played here. It was looking really dire because Stan One's shield was about to break. right? And that's the unfortunate thing, is Legion squandered a big opportunity with the grab so early on. You know, the Reinhardt was put under a ton of pressure to buy enough time to get more ultimates up to find that opportunity. So as long as Legion continue to try and play up tempo here, they now have grab opportunity. They have advantage. They got to recognize that and just pull the trigger.
They got Saucy a pretty big no advantage, but Saucy with no energy gets the pick. Graviton certainly going into Gladiator's Legion. There are no defense ultimates. The Nimbus Gator's going to get pinned away, but the down barrier and over, and those. And that armor is going to help him stay alive. Atlanta Academy do stabilize, but not for long. Is Dalton going to get a pick off his funny Astro? So now 65, now for the Legion. Self-destruct was a cheeky, but not good enough. A pick, though, coming in from Atlanta Academy. RE is going to keep the things out here in this engage that seems to be going on forever.
Oh, this is scrappy. This is as scrappy as you can get. And neither team really wanting to give up any inch of advantage. Legion, because they're playing for their lives right now. They're already down 0-2. If ATL take this, they take the entire series. Oh, no!
Kodak going to go ahead and flex on his Zenyatta as well. Needing to use the Transcendence because he was going to get taken out by the Self-Destruct. Going to go ahead and escort his team into the backline of Gladiator's Legion. Some more pins are coming through. But Funny Asher going to take stand one down before he can connect. Two good picks coming from Atlanta Academy and their supports.
That's one way to save your Rhine from a charge kill. Atlanta Academy right now, they know they're playing with house money, and Legion, you know, I would certainly be starting to get a little bit frustrated here. Despite everything, it seems like you can never find that opportunity. But this is the time to strike. Funny Astro and Kodak both below 50%. Dalton ready with grab. Pull the trigger, Legion.
Not, they have to win a couple fights after this. This going to be an overtime if they capture the second point. It's time to meter the ultimate. You do not want to use all of these at the same time. Water's going to have to use that rally just to get them onto the
pillow.
But it's nice. Speed that got into Hawk is going to open things up. It's going to be a free grab coming in from Dalton with no defense matrix to worry about. There isn't any defensive ultimate for that Graviton Surge. Does Atlanta Academy get wiped?
There we go. Very nice. Legion Dalton just going to, you know, take a bit of a scenic tour. That's how you do it. Atlanta Academy, as, you know, invincibly as they play, it's not always the case. This is a mirror matchup right now, and a lot of times it just comes down to these ultimates. Dalton now does not have grab, but Wolf and Muddy both ready.
Hammer down. Two members are on the ground. Urshad are going the other way. Saucy is going to be on the ground as well as Kodak, but down here is going to save each other respectively. Graviton Surge down coming from Atlanta Academy might be the end of it for Legion. Beautiful charge from a Gator to take the shield out of the equation. Two members get taken down by Hawk. The push is the ending here for Legion, but at least they want some fights to go around, right? It's giving them hope. A lot of times teams need to know that they can win these fights before they can win even more of them.
Exactly. You got to take that first step. And hey, that's a point and half of streets, right? It was looking like it could have been a full hold for Legion just, you know, 40 seconds ago. So not a bad turnaround, but now they got to do it on the defense. And this is where things get really tough against Atlanta Academy. I mean, Gator, he's chomping at the bit, right? This guy, exactly. He's all about go, 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 pure aggression. And, you know, stand one is no Reinhardt to sneeze at, but, you know, sometimes team's playstyle just doesn't suit that all-out aggression. And Legion are a much more measured and much more calculated team. So I don't know if, you know, trying to stand toe-to-toe with ATL is exactly how you do it, but there are multiple times when, say, Gator charged all the way into the Legion backline and just was allowed to walk back to his team. And those are kind of the moments where Legion need to see if they can find a bit more value.
I wish Legion could run Sabra a little bit more effectively, because historically Atlanta Academy have struggled against very good Sombras. They've been okay against Sombras that, you know, are the farming Sombras that have a nice little tempo that's predictable if you're Atlanta Academy, but the good ones out there, like Bunt last season, can have destroyed Atlanta Academy in the past. So the other interesting thing, speaking of Sombras, this group, it doesn't have the Sombras like the other group has.
No.
There is no Jaru here. There is no Butts in this group. The Sombras here are just not as strong. That might be why Atlanta Academy have been finding a little bit more success this season.
Yeah, they do run a very capable Sombra with Saucy. Legion have really yet to find out who on their team can fill that role. They're going to be going with the Ana Goat's look this time around, and always really good because Kodak is going to get trans soon, but if you can find an anti-nade, all of that healing will be for naught, and Legion are playing for those tiny margins right now as Kodak looking to stretch shield, pepper in quite a bit of damage here, and already ATL taking the big long flank around.
They survive the initial biotic grenade. There's 5 seconds before the other one comes up. So Atlantic County are going to give it some nice percentage to get their supports. And they're going to go ahead and start aggressing as Gator going to push Gladiator's Legion off the point already. Stanwood's got to be saved by the Ant, and the sneak goes through. Doesn't hit anybody. Biotic grenade also whiffs. The Gladiator's Legion aren't going to have those cooldowns to help them out here. Some nice displacement, though, is going to keep Atlanta Academy from fully aggressing upon at Legion. The Legion are going to have to do something eventually. This Nano might be what they need.
Yeah, they got it to take a move at some point. There we go. Nano in at 2 kills for a single fire strike. Stanwan, you know, getting a lot of value from his BOGO coupon.
Super. What we like to call it is Atlanta Academy gonna have to go back to the drawing board. That's gotta feel good if you're Stand One, and the momentum is squarely on the Legion side at the moment. Let's see if Atlanta Academy can take things back.
Rolf, though, is going to swap to Zen, so he's gonna have a bit of a trek to get back to point, but Legion know that Saucy's coming up on grab. They gotta have some kind of insurance policy. Bloody is 85% as well, but no support ultimates in hand just yet for Legion. They do have this rally, though, and Stand One, he's had heroics for his
Kodak unable to get that pick with that volley. Gonna have to do that demon self-destruct. It's gonna go through, but Buddy Asher is gonna get pinned out of this game. Earthshatter is also going to be big from Gladiator's Legion, and Atlanta Academy are gonna be approaching the 2-minute warning. You know, struggling a little bit on the objective. They're still trying to fight this out as Hawk and the rest of his team are trying to do some work. Gator gonna go and shatter himself, and he's gonna be taken down a little bit too much invested, I think, in that fight for Atlanta Academy as we're finally starting to see the armor fall.
Yep, Gator choking a bit on too large a chunk of meat right there as, oh man, Hawk thirsting for blood right there. And this is amazing. This is perfect for Legion. They've won 2 fights in a row now here, standing strong. They've got the tools. Bloody used Soundbearer last time. Well, it's fine. Rolf has swapped off his end and will now have Trance. So Gladiator's Legion playing with the confidence that they need. However, now, if ATL drop grab first and take them off guard, this is when Legion have struggled, when they're not controlling the tempo. So they have an option here to grab first.
Dalton's gonna go and do that, but Hawk's going to eat the grab. That's gonna be brutal for their chances in this fight, especially since Stanwood also went down. The Gladiator's Legion playing cleanly so far in this defense. One eat grab is the difference for Atlanta Academy. Hawk, you were hungry, you got fed a little bit of seed, and now Atlanta Academy will be taking this point with 6 ultimates to boot.
Thurston for Stand One's kill, got a grab instead, gonna be happy with that. And ATL, they did use a single ultimate. Now this is a really scary alt economy to be staring down, but Legion do have Transcendence. They just cannot allow for a pick to come through the old-fashioned vanilla way. Make ATL work for it.
I like this rotation that Legion is going through. It's gonna confuse Atlanta Academy. They're gonna away from the payload. They switch sides. Earthshatter gonna hit Bossy, who's in front of the Reinhardt shield. Graviton Surge will be countered with that Transcendence, but another charge onto Lucio. This time, it's gonna be Gator taking out Bloody. Earthshatter once again from Gator, not gonna get hit anybody, but Atlanta Academy still have 6v5. They have to defend the payload as it moves, though, which is a little awkward if you're Atlanta Academy's Hawk almost gets taken down before he gets into the bay. That he does. Water gonna be taking him down. No kills on the self-destruct, so this is still gonna be good news for Legion, who on this rotation have really caused a little bit of a kerfuffle for Atlanta Academy's Kodak Invest to Transcendence, but the Transcendence is going to save you from a charge, my friend.
Oh, and here we have a late fight shatter. There's Stand One trying to be the difference maker for his team, but he does go down. Legion barely clinging on here. Now a scattered, tattered 3v5 team, and they're forced to finally hard reset here. I mean, they shaved a lot of time off of the bank, but they only have a few more meters here. This is when things get really dicey. Saucy will have grab, and Bloody will have Soundbearer, but who wants to pull the trigger first? Dalton has had his grab eaten in the past, so they can force Hawk out of his mech first. We're going to guarantee that.
Dalton's going to get his grab. He's going to burst down the Zarya onto the other side. Soundbearer comes in a little late. The second one's going to be coming in for Legion, and no one is on the payload. Goodness gracious, Contenders teams, come on.
Oh, man.
This has been happening a lot this season.
We need to rename this Letter Number East. Like, this is just the amount of...
I mean, Revival's in the West, so it's pretty split.
Yeah, split, but, you know, welcome to North America, Letter Number. So unlucky. Legion had the tools to win that fight. Great shatter from Gator.
Great shatter.
Great shatter.
That could have been a big reason why they weren't able to get on to the payload. Maybe they're too hyper-focused on the payload, and that's why they all got shattered, but that's after getting the momentum after pushing, you know, a bunch of times off the clock, after buffing Atlanta potentially for another go round, stand one finally coming alive. That's how you end up getting taken out here on a Hollywood, and that's a brutal
it
one
just feels...
if you're Legion. Atlanta Academy continue their golden season as well. They're one map away from finishing out the week, still on tap for that golden season, just like Envy on the other side in North America West. And Atlanta Academy Gladiators Legion this time around has been pretty one-sided. Atlanta Academy has been taking it, but Gladiators Legion coming alive here on Hollywood.
Yeah, you can see ATL's hubris starting to come into play here. Certainly, you know, quite a few moments where they just got ahead of themselves and didn't play quite as cleanly as they needed to, and Legion were able to take advantage. And so it's not as though this Legion squad has no options against ATL. They've got to believe that that's possible and try and stay as disciplined as they can while still keeping themselves hungry for any small window of opportunity. So many charges, man. Both of these Reinhardts really good at finding those long distance hits.
Well, and the other thing about Gator, though, his pins have been a little bit more impactful, I think, where Stig One's gotten a pick on Funny Astro a couple of times. Where have Stig One's pins be taking out his counterpart on the other side, opening that self-destruction up a little bit earlier. Gator has been controlling that fight against that Reinhardt, and Stig One hasn't met a Reinhardt like Gator so far this season, and now that he has, it's someone who could be just as good as you on this tank is going up against you, and is not scared to play against you either. It's been a little bit of a different going for Gladiators Legion. Atlanta Academy have just been killing it so far. Kodak playing Zenyatta, I think, for the first time in a while. Been flexing on that Moira, and that just goes to show Kodak, when he's on Moira, Funny Astro is playing that Zenyatta. Just when you have the capability of being variable in your comps, you can just give so much more, right? You can do so much more just based off of your hero pool in the end, which is becoming more and more important. In the world of GOATs, your base tank only needs really to play Reinhardt.
Yep, it was all about how well do you Rein, and Legion right now struggling a bit since they don't get a ton of flexibility from Emil on this off-tank role. He has had gone with the somber look in the past, you know, lukewarm, we would say. Very, very, very inconsistent results. So that's why Legion are probably sticking to this GOATs comp. But the other problem with Stand One going for the same kind of charges as Gator, we have a friend who kind of reminds me of Gator. You know he's charging on cooldown every single time. But the difficulty with Stand One trying to, you know, match that kind of pace is he's got to protect his backline. Luddy and Rolf die first so often. You see right here, Rolf dies from a lob nade from Saucy, and you know, Stand One needs to keep his shield up in order to try and protect his backline from such attacks. ATL are just so pinpointing where they throw out that damage that, you know, as a Rein, you need to think defensively more than offensively.
Legion just strikes me as a team that was built for a meta that ended up not happening.
Yeah.
If this was still, you know, that GOATs v. GOATs, Legion would most likely still be competing and be a lot closer in this game. But even in, you know, the GOATs versus GOATs, when Kodak was on the Moira, when GOATs is being run from Legion, they're still on the back foot. And GOATs is slowly but surely dying away here in contenders and Overwatch in general. And we're seeing the effectiveness on some of these teams, because it's not just Legion who's struggling with it. I think Skyfoxes have struggled a little bit with it. At least they have, you know, a Sombra that could potentially bring them out of a little bit of a slump. And other teams like Uprising Academy benefiting from that type of change.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, a lot of the teams that struggled with GOATs in the past doing just fine this season. And Legion now are hoping for a win here on Rialto. Pad that map score just a little bit if they can, but it looked like they might be running with the Pharah, but back to GOATs this time around. GOATs still a really great comp to run here on Rialto. It's a very long, winding map, so having the consistency of knowing, hey, we can get grab this fight, we can get grab, and that could be our win condition is very crucial for many of these teams.
Luddy living on the edge, taking in some advantage. Funny Astro is going to be taking a nice high ground advantage, potentially get the boot kill. Yes, he does. Dalton's going to find the water, get two more boot kills, and he's already at 10%.
You know, I don't consider drowning very funny most of the times, but that was pretty prime. That was a prime boop right there. Not very often you find those 3Ks. And
this is an issue that Legion has, though. He's been up there that whole time. What is he waiting for? That exact opportunity, yeah. But they don't take themselves out of that equation.
Yeah, and one of the reasons it's a risky play for most Lucios is a single boop, a single bash will stun you, and you'll find yourself dropping into the middle of the enemy team. Very dangerous here. Right here, he gets booped, manages to escape to safety because Rolf was taken so low. Look at that. He's barely surviving off of just that shielding.
Well, and that goes to show you, one boost is all it took, potentially saving your team. It's also going to get that first pick as we've been on. No brings on either side. Nice displacement coming in from a Luddy. Transcendence is going to be used on Kodak's side, which means Salt is going to have three grabs coming up, and that's going to be where we're going to move for Legion. But no, Rolf is actually going to use that Transcendence. Going to really want to own it this payload. Funny Ash, you're going to get a pick, but some interesting ultimate usage, I think, from both sides. Transcendence used to save members of their team. Nothing really going on either side.
Look at how Kodak is targeting Rolf, who hasn't been behind his Ryan's shield for a lot of this. Bomb out now too, and finally ATL dropping a couple of members here, Legion finding their way forward. But you know, there is something to be said with the strategy that they were running, right? Keep pressing, keep the pressure on even when you lose members, because you know you can rely, you can lean a little bit on those attacking spawn advantages to get numbers against ATL. And hey, if it works, it works, but Legion can't rely on that same mechanic throughout the rest of this map, and that's what they gotta keep in mind here.
Legion dropping three ultimates, Atlanta Academy will be able to match that. Dalton, unfortunately, missing a window where Kodak would not have had trans after the grab. They won that last fight, so it wasn't available for them to take advantage of that opening. Atlanta Academy, though, are gonna call Fisher to just grab it on third. Kodak still not using the Transcendence, he's going to use it a little late. They're actually going to probably find a ton more value out of it because of this Earthshatter following. So that's a confident play coming in from Kodak. That's a good game sense coming in from that Zenyatta of Atlanta Academy. Hawk using that self-destruct is going to be able to get back in it to the mech, and we're seeing the poor little Brig trying to run away. Going to charge back, shield dash back on it to the plane. She's still alive. She's still alive. There she goes. And that's a Brig stagger along with a Lucio emote. The DM is strong with this Atlanta team, but I like the character.
Yeah, it's certainly something. Gladiator's Legion now. That is a supremely confident and, nay I say, disrespectful play to not trance. ATL knew that Legion could not find the focus fire, could not find the damage to find a kill in that grab, and now they have sound barriers saved and Kodak with nearly another trance racked up and Legion running out of options. They have no ultimates and they don't really have any space either.
Rolf came into that fight low. I feel like he's been low at the beginning of a lot of these fights this time around, though. It's going to be Water and Emil who are going to need that HP. Graviton Surge coming through from Fozzy. There's nothing on the other side. Rolf is unable to find that Transcendence in time. They will have it for the next one, but there might not be a next one.
Bloody is going to be one of the first ones out of respawn, but it doesn't look likely here. Legion, this is probably where things are going to stop for them, and that's a tough spot to hold. Courtyard is a difficult place to hold back, but you know, hey, we've seen crazier things. But something I just want to point out again is that Legion need to watch. It's really tough because it's like, well, you know, play with a bit more intention, right? But also at the same time, don't play with so much intention that your supports get picked first, right? Mm-hmm. And Atlanta Academy, because they have, you know, they're just pulling on the reins the entire time, they have no concerns about their ability to execute, right? So it's a lot easier to remember positioning and, you know, barrier usage and keeping Kodak and Funny Astro safe. And Legion, you know, they kind of have to think about 365 things all at once, and they're struggling right now against Atlanta Academy because they don't play in the same kind of aggressive style, and at the same, and you know, also in the same breath, they're not able to keep their supports alive, which is going to really hamper your ability to push forward and take space.
When you're also losing the Ghost matchup, the thing that you probably came in most prepared for, it's just the cards are not on the table for you. Things just aren't going your way, and Atlanta Academy playing super clean as well. Using, it's very reminiscent of Envy last season. Envy this season is definitely a little bit of a different kind of look with Lulzish and Ellie Boat picking up a lot of the steam that Trill left over, but they're kind of defined by their versatility and consistency. Atlanta is definitely the explosivity, right? That they can come out of nowhere, and all of a sudden four ults are coming your way, and they all have them back again by the time the next fight starts.
Yeah, ATL is the definition of 0 to 60 in 3 seconds. the Gladiators Legion right now struggling to match that pace, and on the defense, they don't need to match that pace. They need to stay alive, which is much harder. See here, Luddy on that same high ground, but not going for the same kind of risky plays. And look at the way that Hawk immediately dives into the backline. Where is Water? If this happens all the time to your team, that your backline is constantly getting picked by a super aggressive tank line, you gotta stay back just a little bit for the bash, for the flail, to see if you can do something against this aggression. Right now, Emil, oh, well, he actually escapes with his mech. That's really good news.
This kind of reminds me, remember there, I think it was in Planet Earth in the ocean, when like the seals and the dolphins all come, and they're eating the krill in that like, Atlanta Academy are the sharks of this situation, mm-hmm. and right now Gladiators Legion is acting as if the krill get eaten up from every which side, and they're getting isolated. The smaller the group, the easier it is to get picked off. Atlanta Academy does such a good job picking people off and isolating members of the opposing team. Earthshatter, though, not going to be doing just that. And Atlanta Academy have to wait for another ultimate. Sugar Free going to use that rally just in time. Kodak is going to be on it in the ground. Sugar Free is still alive, however, and Atlanta Academy will be functioning with all six members. Got to stay on at the point. You don't want another situation where you lose because you're just not on the payload. Don't have much room to it goes. Gladiators Legion are coming up very soon on a Graviton Surge, but when you're on the ground, you can't use it. You can't develop a Gator with another really nice Shatter. Should lock things up here for Atlanta Academies. They're going to do a little bit of emote control to end things here. Atlanta Academy continue their golden season 4-0 against Gladiators Legion, and in my opinion, a pretty surprising fashion, mm-hmm. being so dominant. Yeah. We knew Atlanta was good, but Atlanta is this good. We talked about contenders and pretenders. Mm-hmm. These guys mm-hmm. are contenders for sure.
Oh, absolute heroes when others are zeros. And the scary thing, again, is that Atlanta Academy seem like they have so few weaknesses, right? A lot of times you're like, oh, well, if you just shore up your support line, you'll be doing great. If you just find a little bit more, you know, of that oomph in your tank line, you'll be great. And Atlanta Academy, honestly, playing a nigh-perfect game there, you know, stands a couple of, you know, moments where maybe a little bit too overeager, but Gladiators Legion do have quite a bit of work ahead, right? You got to find that same kind of aggression in your tank line. You have to keep your supports safe. You got to watch for that Brigitte positioning and the D.Va positioning. It's a really hard thing because when you're, you know, constantly hanging back and thinking about how are my supports doing, then you're not thinking about how to push forward. And I think Atlanta Academy are really able to take advantage of that fact.
I'd love to just see them try something different. Right, something like no pressure. Right, let's try this crazy thing. Let's try the double main tank that Envy's doing right
now.
Yeah,
Orisa Winston. Right,
let's try the Orisa Winston and see how we are. Let's try Clockwork because that is becoming a little bit more popular. Clockwork killing it in European contenders right now, so we know it can work. But as of right now, Gladiators Legion on a 2-game losing streak. That's going to put Grunto squarely in second mm-hmm. place before their game today. And that's going to be it for Atlanta and Gladiators Legion. Once again, Atlanta takes that 4-0 in a clean sweep, keeping their golden season alive, not dying between Paris and about halfway Ooh. Through the third map. That is something I don't think I have seen so far as a contenders cast.
Yeah, I'd love to see some stats on that. Just seeing, like, you know, where their peaks and dives are, because that, I mean, that's just pure, utter domination at that point.
Yep, and so that's going to be it for us for the first game. Our second game, though, is going to be a big one in terms of the playoff picture. Mm-hmm. It's going to be Uprising Academy versus Phase 2, both with the same record. Whoever wins this today will most likely be good to go for those playoffs, and we really want to get to that one, so we'll see you in six.